Hello everyone, welcome back to another RShiny tutorial. In the previous video, we saw how we could create inputs and display the text in a particular Shiny application. So let's look at what we did earlier. If I run this app, you'll see we created two drop downs. One is region and product category. I had two different values within it, region 1 and region 2. And for product category, I had category 1 and category 2. If I selected them, you'll see that I was able to display the values within each of these drop downs in this particular section. Now, we are going to obviously work with data and it's always not going to be static like this. So, what we're going to do now is let's work on another example where we take the inputs from a particular data set, right? And then we'll evolve it from there. So, in this particular video, what we're going to do is we're going to work on a basic app where we are showing a bar plot and we're going to use some external data to create our Shiny dashboard. We'll begin with the basic framework. We have library Shiny here. Then we're going to take server function, input, output, and session. And then we're going to also have a UI basic page. Then I'm going to create an application by saying UI is equal to UI. That is this portion, and server is equal to server. That is this portion. So I'm going to put my cursor in the server section and we are going to first begin by putting an output plot in this particular section, right? So it's going to be looking something like this. I'm going to say output dollar plot, and then I'm going to say render plot. Now render plot helps us to plot whatever is there within this particular server into the UI, right? And we're going to take this element and then put it in the basic page so that it displays the chart. I'm also then going to put a curly bracket. Now we have that function ready where we can place the elements. First, we'll begin by taking the sales data, which we will be using shortly. So it's going to be read.csv. And then I'm going to give the link and then I'm going to get say header is equal to true because my data will have header, and then separation comma separation is going to be equal to comma. So now I have that header is equal to true and we have this. So this is the file we require. So the file that we have is going to look something like this. I've placed it in the same folder wherever I have the code here. And then I'm going to also take the data that's going to look like this, right? Now, I know we started with some other data set, but I'm taking a simple data set so that we could basically do lots of things and you can see with clarity what's happening. So this is the sales data. We have sales representative. We have four different sales representatives. We have regions, north, south, east, west. And then we have quarter, Q1 to Q4, sales and units sold. We're going to just try to plot sales or units sold, for example. Once we have this location here, what we'll do is we'll try to fit that particular data and see how we can plot this particular data. So to plot it, what we will do is I will just create the plot here. I'm just going to say hashtag plot, and then I'm going to say a simple plot like, let's say sales, and then I'm going to take dollar and I'm going to take sales as a example, right? So basically what I'm really doing is just taking this as an input and I'm going to say insert and just trying to plot it something like this, right? So it's just going to take sales and just going to plot it on a particular chart. So if I move here now, that's the first thing that we have set up, right? So we took the sales data and then now we are taking bar plot of the sales variable and then plotting that. Now, obviously this is not going to show in the basic page unless we specifically call it out and show it. Right. So how will we do that? I'm going to begin by saying H1 and then open bracket. Within that, I'm going to say R Shiny bar plot. So I have that now. And next thing, we're going to say plot output. And then now, what's the output that we want to plot? So whatever name is available here will be going here. Right. So if I have something like here, I can simply put that to be here, but obviously plot is better. So we're just going to say plot, and this is also going to be plot. Now I have this output here where I have a heading and the plot that we just created here, right? So essentially what we are doing is we create the plot in the server with the data, and we just take the output that is there within this basic page and show it, right? So we show that by putting a header and then also by putting a plot output. And any output that you want to put it, you need to comma separate it. So I'm going to take header first, and then I'm going to say comma, and then put the next thing that we want to display here, right? So once that is done, obviously the app is ready, and now we can run this app and see what's happening. So if I just say run app, it will give me this notification. It means that I need to just save it and then run it. So I'm going to say save selected and then run this particular app. So you'll see no lines available in input showing here, right? So which means there is some error. So let's look at why that particular error came. So the error came because obviously we missed the file name. So I'm just going to take the file name that we have here. Take this one, place it here, and it should be working. So if I run this app now, say save selected. It's stuck, so I just hit the escape. Okay, now it's come in. So basically you have this shiny bar plot, and like we had within the Excel file, this particular plot is now plotted within this, right? But this is still not functional, right? Why it's not functional? Remember, we wanted to have some input within it and then show it, right? Obviously, the first step was to get the chart in place. So in the next video, what we will do is we'll now try to put a drop down within the data and then modify the data in such a way that we can plot it using a drop down. So let's see how that will happen in the next video.